Coming up, we'll look at the latest updates to running your SAP HANA workloads on Azure, and some of the benefits like scale on demand, increased performance, analytics, and security. Azure offers on-demand M-series virtual machines and purpose-built HANA Large Instances, both certified to support your SAP workloads. The M-series can support most of your SAP workloads, allowing you to scale up to 128 virtual CPUs of compute and 4 terabytes of RAM. On the other hand, purpose-built HANA Large Instances are great for your larger SAP workloads, giving you up to 20 terabytes of RAM. Let's start by showing you how to get an SAP HANA environment running on Azure. In terms of automation, we have several options. By searching SAP on the marketplace, you'll see a number of SAP images and templates. The same is true for the Azure portal. As you can see, I've already selected the SAP solution template for a 3-tier deployment. This will create the infrastructure for deployment of HANA on SUSE Linux, ASCS, and application servers. To kick this off, we can start with the basic settings. I've completed the information in advance, so let me walk you through it. We need to set a username, password, subscription, and resource group. And then I'll need to set up a new 3-character SAP system ID. Next, you'll select your SAP system size based on the number of SAPs you want to run. And of course, if you're not sure about the size you need, you can always refer to your documentation or talk to your SAP admin. The final step is to select a virtual network and configure the subnet. Once you're ready, we just have to wait for the portal to validate the template and hit OK. Once that's done, we'll just hit Create. When this is finished, you'll have the infrastructure in place to deploy your SAP images. The second option you can use for non-production workloads is to set up a single instance environment with SAP HANA installed as part of the process. For this, let's go over to GitHub. This is a great option for quickly standing up a training or dev test environment. As you can see, this is just like any other Azure Resource Manager template. And of course, I can just go in and modify this JSON template to add or configure resources as needed. The first thing we need to do for this deployment is to download the SAP HANA installation media from SAP, and then upload it to a place where it's publicly accessible. In this case, I'll be using Azure Storage. The automated process will install SAP HANA from this location. Now we're ready to deploy. Let's go back to GitHub. From here, I only need to hit the Deploy to Azure button, and I'll be redirected into the portal. To save time, I've already populated the parameters for my custom deployment. There are a few things to point out here. You have a number of options for VM size, but we recommend the M-series, as they're certified for SAP HANA and optimized for database workloads. As you can see, I've also enabled Write Accelerator. This optimizes the performance of database writes. Finally, you can also go ahead and set your HANA system ID and HANA instance number to customize your deployment. Once you're ready, agree to the terms and hit Purchase. The end-to-end deployment takes around 30 minutes versus days or weeks in a traditional on-premises environment. Once provisioned, it will create a HANA virtual machine, a jump box, and all the necessary infrastructure. It also installs and configures SAP HANA for you. When it's done, you can start using HANA Studio from the Windows Server Jumpbox VM. And from here, let's take a look at performance. You saw earlier that we selected the Write Accelerator, which allows for write transactions in the database to be much faster for our VM. To show you some of the performance benefits, I'm going to call a stored procedure to insert 10,000 rows into my database. This is common to any batch order or receiving process. I have 2 VMs, one with Write Accelerator and one without. Let's start by kicking off the one without Write Accelerator. Next, I'll start the second VM, which has Write Accelerator enabled. While this is running, I'll tell you a few things about it. First, the Write Accelerator is available only on M-series VMs for databases, so that we can get an even faster throughput on writes of DBMS transactions. Also, a great use case for Write Accelerator is speeding up log writes for SAP HANA. So that took 13.7 seconds, but let's go back to look at the one without Write Accelerator enabled. UC is still running. And there we go. That completed in almost 32 seconds. So the Write Accelerator enabled VM took less than half the time for a 10,000 row batch insert. Beyond performance, though, let's now look at scale. As with all Azure virtual machines, you have the capability to scale up and down on demand, only pay for the compute that you need, and we can also do this with minimal downtime. For example, we can take the VM that I provisioned earlier and scale it up in size. My current VM has 64 virtual CPUs and 1 terabyte of RAM, and I want to scale it up to 128 virtual CPUs and close to 4 terabytes of RAM, which is the maximum size allowed for a VM. I'll hit select, and in a few moments, it will resize. So now that you have your SAP HANA workloads in Azure, there are additional management, security, and analytics advantages. Monitoring and managing of your Azure VMs is built in through the Azure Security Center. Azure is monitoring that I have the latest updates applied, and my disks are encrypted. If I go back to the dashboard, you'll see that Azure monitors the security state of my networking, storage, and applications. You can also use Azure to host your SAP HANA backups. So that was a quick overview on how you can run your SAP HANA workloads on Azure and take advantage of increased scale, performance, security, and analytics. We guarantee a 4.9 SLA for SAP HANA large instances and a 3.5.9 SLA for SAP HANA on M-Series VMs, which are rolling out globally across Azure regions. To learn more, check out the link shown. Thanks for watching.